It is easy to forget that when you are using the SPSS drop-down menus to explore and analyze data, that what you are really doing is writing code. SPSS requires computer code, called syntax, that actually makes the analysis run. When you know about syntax, you have a secret weapon for making SPSS more powerful. We are going to dive deeper into how to use syntax in SPSS. The best way to explain syntax is to show it to you in action. So imagine that I'm doing a class project using the dataset demo.sav. Open SPSS. And then open the demo dataset. I will begin by running a few analyses. I will get the descriptive statistics and frequencies for marital status, including a bar chart with percentages. Then I'm going to run a t-test to see whether males or females have higher average income. Finally, I will correlate household income with years at current address and the years with current employer. So notice what I have done with each of these examples. For each test, instead of clicking OK, I clicked the Paste button. With each analysis, syntax has been added to my syntax window. Now before I close this dataset, double-click in the output and select this set of commands that opened the dataset. I will add them to the top of my syntax window. Save the syntax to the desktop. And then close SPSS. So we will pretend that it has been a few days since I have created this syntax and used this dataset. I begin by opening SPSS. Once the software opens, I'm going to open the syntax window. Even if I can't remember where I left my dataset, all I need to do is press the green triangle to run selection. SPSS finds and opens the dataset, it runs each of the analyses, and everything is available in the output window. I can now use the export command to export everything to Microsoft Word. So why am I showing you this? In addition to being pretty cool that I can run an entire analysis with just a few clicks, there are some tremendous benefits to using syntax. Syntax allows you to automate common tasks. Saving the syntax from an analysis, especially a complex analysis in which you are making small tweaks to variables or settings, allows you to repeat an analysis without having to go through each step using the drop-down menus. If we are collaborating on a project and the analysis is complex, I do not have to try to explain each step to you using the drop-down menus and settings. I can simply email you the syntax and the dataset. You open the data, run the syntax, and you have replicated my analysis. Perhaps, as part of our project, you have new data to add to the dataset. Well, the thing is, I have already run an analysis. No problem. You can add your new data to our dataset, you make your additions, and then you rerun the tests. As long as the variable names in your dataset are the same as in mine, you can use my syntax. or you can edit my syntax to work with your variable names. Another big advantage to knowing how to use syntax is there are some things that you simply cannot do with drop-down menus. You must use the command syntax language. And, as you have seen, you do not need to learn how to code to use syntax in SPSS. SPSS will write this syntax for you, and you can copy or edit as you please. The only downside is that the use of syntax may or may not be available with the limited student versions of SPSS. If not, you will need to go to your computer lab to use the full version at your university. You can edit SPSS syntax or write your own. Look at this syntax. Syntax has both commands, in the dark blue, and subcommands, in green. The first line, frequencies, is the command. Bar chart is a subcommand. We know that it is a subcommand by the slash in front of it. Notice that the frequencies command does not have a slash. I asked for the bar chart to show percentages, but perhaps I would rather report for the raw numbers or the frequencies. All I need to do is delete the word percent. I know that I want to report frequencies, but perhaps I can't remember what the precise command is. If I type an F, SPSS will show me my options for the bar chart. I can choose the frequency option. Return, add two spaces, and then type a forward slash to create a new subcommand. Let's change the format. It is okay if you do not know all of the commands. Just begin typing and you can see the options. I will sort descending, which is D value. Using the right click, I can click anywhere inside of a command, then select the command. And then I can right click again and choose Run Selection. Another helpful feature is to follow the color code of the syntax. When a command is recognized, it turns red. As long as the command is red, it is not ready to run yet. If you misspell a command, it will not turn red as you would expect. The syntax must be followed by a period in order to run. You can add comments to your syntax using the command comment. However, I think it is easier to simply use an asterisk. This is a good place to add your research questions right before an analysis, so you will know which research question the analysis refers to. Notice how the command following the comment will be grayed out until you add a period at the end of the comment. And finally, the syntax is not case sensitive. The convention, however, is to type commands and subcommands in all caps, and the name of the variables in lowercase. You do not need to run the entire block of syntax at once. In fact, sometimes you only want to run a small portion, then stop, look at the output, and then run the next portion. To do this, use breakpoints. Breakpoints allow you to stop the execution of a syntax command at a certain point, and then continue running the syntax when you are ready. Breakpoints must be set at the level of the command, not within the command, so you cannot stop at a subcommand. To insert a breakpoint, click anywhere within the command in the left column. Click on the red circle icon to insert the breakpoint. It will be inserted after the command. When you run the syntax, the run will stop at the red circle. To resume running, choose Run, Continue. I mentioned a scenario in which you and I are collaborating, and I send you a data set with syntax. What do you do then? Well, first, open the data set.
Double-click on the SPSS data set to open it. Now, double-click on the syntax file. Commands will only run on the active data set. You can have other data sets open. Just make sure that you have the one that you want to use pulled to the front. If not, you will get an error message about not being able to find the variable names. You are now ready to run this syntax on your data set.
I have other things that I will teach you about using syntax, but for now, just know that when you use SPSS, you are actually writing computer code. And knowing how to use that computer code can save you lots of time and make you a power user with SPSS.